Hi there everyone. Today I'm going to show you guys how to fix the gimbal calibration error 40011 using the Drone Hacks software. But first I'm going to show you guys how the error looks like. You connect to the drone and you see it says gimbal calibration error. You can go to the calibration section in the app, go to control, scroll down, select calibrate gimbal. Now in my case, the camera is able to move on startup, left, right, all of that. No problems there, and it calibrates properly, but the error just doesn't want to go away. As you can see, it's successful, no problems there, but the error remains. Now don't worry about the take or failed message, that's just because my Mini is connected to my PC. So what you want to do is open your browser, type in Drone Hacks by Think Awesome, open the link, you'll see the page open, and on the top right you're going to get the download page. Scroll down and select DJI, and then select whichever version of operating system you're using, in my case Windows 10. So pick the one you want, click on the download link, and it's going to start downloading. I'm going to cancel the download because I already have it downloaded to my machine. The great thing is there's no need to install it, you're just going to double click it and it's going to open. Now once it opens, there's no need to log in or anything like that, so don't worry about that. And you see on the right side there is trying to connect to a Mavic Mini. If you click on that, it's going to show you the instructions that you need to connect to your Mavic Mini. Now Mavic Minis are a bit weird, you need to turn it on and then connect it to your machine. So essentially just follow the instructions on the screen and you're going to see what I mean. So you can see there, turn on the Mavic Mini, then connect the USB cable to the Mini, and then it's going to detect by the system. So in my case, I'm just turning it on quickly, so just give it a couple of seconds. Once it connects, you're going to see in the black little lock scroll at the top, where it shows you that it's connected. It'll say device connected, and you should be able to see it in the top there. As you can see, I'm highlighting it now. Once it's connected, you're going to click on the Hack/Flash Firmware tab, then click on the download firmware option, and it's automatically going to open the Dank drone downloader page and populate everything for you automatically. So you just click on the submit button and you can download the correct firmware from there. Now please note, it's going to show up the latest firmware first, and you can see the release notes there as well. Click the button and you can download it. Remember, this is the latest firmware, but we don't want the latest firmware. So once it's done, it'll automatically go back to the previous page, but please select the 3201. That is the firmware that is used for calibration. So you can see in the release notes there as well, it's specific for the calibration options. Now once that's done, you can then go to the bottom, select the choose firmware option, scroll to where you downloaded it, and then highlight and start the firmware update. So just click flash firmware and it's going to run through the whole process. It's going to take a little while, it takes up to like 5 or 6 minutes, but in this case you're going to see that I've sped it up a bit because it's just going to take too long for us to wait for the whole process. So if you want, you can skip through a little bit, but it's going to go through a few processes and all these steps are going to have to complete. So please don't touch your drone or remove anything from the system, it has to complete everything. So in some cases you might notice that the firmware downloads with a .tar extension. You can just rename it to a .bin and it will still work. So don't worry too much about that. Okay, so it's now completed. You can just click the OK button and then close the Drone Hacks application. No need for it anymore. And we can open our drone and see, or start up our drone and see if everything's working properly. So connect to your drone, click on the Go Fly option. You might see a firmware upgrade option, just ignore it for now. And you see the error is still there. So don't be too worried yet. We're now just going to do a calibration. And you'll see it's still going to complete properly as before, no change. However, the biggest advantage now is we're using the calibration firmware, so now it will take the calibration and save it onto the drone itself. Almost done. just takes a bit longer than previously. As you can see, it's still looking left, right, up, down on the background. The calibration is still carrying on. Now, remember, my drone could calibrate all the time. Some guys get this error message and the gimbal is stuck. That's a completely different error. So in this case, you can see that we are on the right firmware version. We've checked now, the error is now gone and everything's good. So in this case, our error has now been resolved. The mini gimbal calibration error is now gone, but we are still on the older firmware. So what you can do is you can update the firmware. It should be in your main menu and you can just tap that and you'll upgrade to the latest firmware automatically. Now, if you don't get the update message, go to the GoFly option, tap the three dots on the top right and go to the About section. On the About section, you'll see your firmware version. If it's not the same as this one, you can click to check for updates and it will automatically check it for you. Thank you guys very much for watching. Please remember to leave a like and a comment and subscribe if you guys enjoyed this.